You're on the bottom, you got two choices. You stay down or you pick yourself up. You can succeed when no one believes in you. You have no chance to succeed if you do not believe in yourself.
Event number one is the vertical jump. The vertical jump event measures lower body strength. Scoring is determined by the distance between the examinee's recorded reach and the best of three recorded jumps in inches. The examinee is required to stand with their side to the wall, either right or left. The examinee must then hold the magnet cylinder in the hand closest to the wall and position their feet flat on the floor. They then reach up as high as possible to place the magnet cylinder on the board to establish the point of reference from which the vertical jump will be measured. Before jumping, the examinee must be in a position so that either their right or left foot is no more than 12 inches from the wall. The foot closest to the wall must remain stationary prior to the jump. The examinee then jumps as high as possible and places the magnet cylinder on the vertical jump board using the hand closest to the wall. The best of three jumps is recorded on the MCOL score sheet. The proctor scores the jump to the nearest half inch between the two marked positions recorded on the vertical jump test board. In the event the instrument does not record a completed jump, the examinee will be permitted another jump. Event number two is the sit-up event. The sit-up event measures core body strength. The examinee is required to complete as many sit-ups as possible in 60 seconds. The examinee starts the event by lying on their back on a gym mat. The examinee's knees are bent 90 degrees, with feet flat on the floor, and with hands overlapped behind the head. The examinee's feet are held tight to the floor by another examinee. After the examinee indicates they are set, the proctor with the timer starts the event with ready, go. One complete sit-up has occurred when the examinee raises their shoulders from the mat, keeping their hands overlapped behind their heads, touches their elbows to their knees, example left elbow to left knee, and finally returns to the down position and touches their shoulder blades on the mat. The examinee may rest in the down position only. Only sit-ups performed in the manner outlined above will be counted. Event number three is push-ups. The push-up event measures upper body strength. The examinee is required to do as many push-ups as possible in 60 seconds. This event is performed on the floor without a mat. The examinee must correctly position the center of their breastbone over the 3-inch indicator. The examinee's hands are to be positioned shoulder-width apart, with their feet no more than 6 inches apart. After the examinee indicates they are set, the proctor with the timer starts the event with ready, go. One complete push-up has occurred when the examinee starts in the up position with elbows locked, moves downward, keeping their legs, hips, and torso in the same plane, strikes the 3-inch indicator with their breastbone, and finally returns to the up position, keeping their legs, hips, and torso in the same plane. The examinee may rest only with their arms fully extended in the up locked position. Event number four is the shuttle run. The 1/2 mile shuttle run event measures cardiorespiratory capacity and includes elements of cardiovascular endurance, aerobic power, and agility. This is a timed event that requires the examinee to complete 15 round trips between two pylons that are placed 88 feet apart. The examinee runs from the starting pylon to the far pylon, around it, and back to the starting pylon. This is one round trip. It is repeated for a total of 15 round trips. After the examinee indicates they are set, the proctor starts the event with ready, go. The proctor will inform the examinee when they have completed 5, 10, and 13 round trips. The event is timed from the command go until the examinee crosses the pylon on the completion of the 15th round trip. Event number 5 is the 24-foot extension ladder raise. The ladder raise is designed to measure upper body strength of the examinee. This event is to be conducted in turnout fire coat, fire gloves, fire helmet, and a self-contained breathing apparatus, or SCBA. It should be noted that the examinee will not be required to be on air for the completion of this test. Examinees are allowed to wear shorts or sweats and athletic shoes during this event. The examinee will go to a standing 24-foot extension ladder. The examinee shall raise the fly section of the ladder to the rung indicated with a red piece of tape. The examinee shall lock the ladder in the extended position. When instructed to do so by the proctor, the examinee shall then return the fly section back to the ground. Event number 6 is the tower obstacle course. The tower obstacle course measures the examinee's ability to negotiate obstacles in a low visibility and reduced spaced environment. This event is to be conducted in a fire turnout coat, fire gloves, fire helmet, and SCBA pack. It should be noted that the examinee will not be required to be on air during the completion of this test. The examinee will start at the entrance to the tower as indicated by the proctor. Examinee will begin the event on his or her hands or knees. The proctor will tell the examinee to begin when they are ready. Following a rope as the examinee's guide, the examinee will navigate into the tower and through the design course that will include crawling through a corrugated tubing, underneath a low level deck, and over a couch. The examinee must continue along the path designated by the rope and exit out the other side of the tower to complete this event. This event will be scored as being completed or not completed in terms of evaluation. The 7th event is the 100-foot aerial ladder climb. The aerial ladder climb measures the applicant's ability to climb a ladder approximately 100 feet into the air. This event is to be conducted in a fire turnout coat, fire gloves, fire helmet, and self-contained breathing apparatus, or SCBA pack. It should be noted that the examinee shall not be required to be on air for the completion of this test. Examinees shall start at the base of the turnstile with both feet on the turnstile and both hands grasping the rung directly in front of them. When set, the proctor shall inform the examinee to begin when ready, and also inform the examinee that this is not a timed event, only completed or not completed. The examinee shall climb the ladder one rung at a time, touching the rung indicated with a piece of tape. Examinee will then climb down the ladder one rung at a time. The examinee has successfully completed the event when both feet return to the turnstile of the apparatus.